What if the key to predicting Earth's future was millions of years in the making? Scientists have unearthed ice that could be up to 1.5 million years old, and what's trapped inside could rewrite everything we thought we knew about our planet's past. Get ready, because today on the Infographic Show, we're cracking open the frozen mystery of one of Earth's oldest ice cores. Before we uncover what could be hidden within this ancient ice, we need to understand how drilling for ice cores works and what they can tell us about our planet. Ice cores are long cylinders of compact snow and frozen water that are drilled and extracted from glaciers and ice sheets. They can vary in length from several meters to several kilometers in length. The deeper the extraction and the longer the ice core is, the further back in the Earth's past it comes from. Each layer of the ice is like a page in Earth's diary. Trapped inside are tiny air bubbles from ancient atmospheres, particles from volcanic eruptions, and remnants of dust storms. It can even provide clues about wind patterns from hundreds or thousands, or in the case of the most recent excavation, millions of years ago. Since the 1960s, scientists have braved the cold to drill ice cores from all over the world. They've ventured into the frigid ice packs of the Arctic, to the frozen, windswept desert that is Antarctica, just to extract ice that could help us better understand our planet. But not all of the ice core expeditions are created equal. In freezing polar conditions, scientists use mechanical drills that consist of big, spiral-tipped tools that cut into the rock-hard ice. In warmer areas where the ice can actually be melted, they use thermal drills that melt through the ice. But no matter the method, the goal is the same: bring up ancient ice without disturbing the precious data trapped inside. Once extracted, the ice cores are usually cut into 3-foot-long segments for easier transport and storage. In order to maintain the integrity of the cores and the information held within, scientists primarily drill for cores in regions where the snow has accumulated year after year for thousands or even millions of years. These ideal drilling sites include the massive ice sheets of Antarctica and Greenland, where compacted layers of snow have built up over millennia, forming ice that can be several miles thick. The sheer depth of these ice sheets makes them perfect for retrieving long cores that preserve a detailed record of past climate conditions. In addition to the polar regions, scientists also extract cores from high-altitude mountain glaciers and ice caps in areas such as North and South America, Eurasia, and parts of the Himalayas. These sites are crucial for understanding regional climate patterns, which can vary significantly from global climate trends. By comparing ice cores from different parts of the world, researchers can distinguish between local environmental changes and broader planet-wide shifts in climate. This global network of ice core drilling locations allows scientists to piece together a more complete and accurate picture of Earth's climate history. You might think that trekking across a landscape so cold that it could cause you to freeze to death would be the hard part, but this is just the beginning. Things get really tricky when scientists need to store the ice cores and analyze the data. In fact, ice core storage is a whole science of its own. The National Science Foundation Ice Core Facility, or NSF-ICF, in Lakewood, Colorado, is home to thousands of ice core samples from Greenland, Antarctica, and North America. Its massive freezer holds 56,500 cubic feet of ice, and it's kept at a bone-chilling negative 33 degrees Fahrenheit. They have an on-site exam room at the facility for initial studies, but most deep-dive analyses happen off-site. Scientists use specialized equipment to measure things like ancient CO2 levels and isotope ratios that reveal past temperatures. So why are these ice cores so important, and what can they actually tell us? When snow falls, it doesn't come down alone. It carries microscopic hitchhikers, such as dust, volcanic ash, pollen, and even smoke particles. As that snow compresses into ice, it locks these particles into place along with tiny bubbles of air. That trapped air is especially important. It contains real samples of ancient atmospheres, including greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide and methane. By analyzing the gas content in these bubbles, scientists can track how Earth's atmosphere has changed over the years. They can then connect those changes to temperature shifts, extinction events, and even geological processes. Volcanic eruptions are one of the clearest examples of how ice cores preserve Earth's climate history. When a volcano erupts, it releases ash, gases, and sometimes massive amounts of sulfur dioxide. That sulfur dioxide gets converted into sulfate aerosols in the upper atmosphere, which reflect sunlight and temporarily cool the planet. Ice cores have captured the chemical fingerprint of these eruptions, especially the large sulfur-rich ones near the equator that had global cooling effects. Not only can scientists detect volcanic ash in the ice, but in some cases, they can even trace it back to the exact volcano it came from. This helps provide an exact timeline of past eruptions and their climactic consequences. And that is just the beginning. Dust in the ice hints at ancient droughts and desertification. Pollen tells scientists what kind of plants were growing nearby. Smoke particles suggest how widespread wildfires were in the past. Even the structure of the ice layers themselves can offer insights into wind patterns and seasonal weather. For example, multiple cores from the same region may show the effect of snowdrifts, indicating dominant wind directions at different times in history. Unique changes in snow caused by 24-hour summer sunlight can also help distinguish between summer and winter layers. But perhaps the most powerful tool of all is locked inside of the water itself. Ice, after all, is just frozen H2O, and water holds a subtle but reliable record of temperature. The key lies in oxygen isotopes and variants of oxygen atoms with different weights. Light oxygen, which has 8 protons and 8 neutrons, evaporates more quickly, while heavy oxygen, which consists of 8 protons and 10 neutrons, condenses more quickly. As an air mass travels toward the poles, it loses the heavier isotopes first. That means the deeper into the polar ice sheet scientists drill, the more that they can track the ratio of light to heavy oxygen in each layer. Fewer heavy oxygen isotopes in a layer signals colder conditions when that snow fell. By decoding ice layer composition along with air bubbles, particles, isotopes, and other information in the ice cores, scientists can reconstruct a climate timeline stretching back hundreds of thousands of years. Ice cores don't just tell us what the weather was like, they reveal how Earth's climate system works, how it responds to natural and human forces, and what changes might still lie ahead. In short, ice cores are one of our most powerful tools for reading Earth's frozen history. And that's what makes the newly excavated ice core so exciting. Collected by an international team of scientists, it holds clues to Earth's climate going back hundreds of thousands of years. What sets this core apart is that it contains ice far older than most samples ever recorded. In order to obtain this new ice core, scientists had to pull off one of the most ambitious and exciting feats in climate research history by successfully drilling 1.7 miles deep into the Antarctic ice sheet. This pristine, glassy cylinder of ancient ice, drilled from beneath Little Dome Sea in East Antarctica, may be well over 1.2 million years old, with some scientists claiming that it could contain ice that's around 1.5 million years old. This ice formed at a time when Earth's climate system was going through one of its biggest transitions in history. But more on that later. The drilling took 4 Antarctic summers, with a dedicated team of scientists and engineers operating in brutal temperatures with an average of about minus 18 degrees Fahrenheit. The ice was extracted, cut into sections, carefully packed, and shipped across the globe to the UK. It's currently being slowly melted in a state-of-the-art clean room to unlock the mysteries held within. As the ice melts, it'll release ancient dust, ash, and even microscopic marine algae particles that have been preserved in time. Using tools like inductively coupled plasma mass spectrometry, or ICPMS, scientists will analyze more than 20 elements and trace metals, unlocking data on the past. Even the younger ice that's less than 800,000 years old is being put to work. Since scientists already have regular access to cores from this time period from other excavations, researchers are using these layers to test and refine their equipment and methods. This is being done to ensure that by the time they reach the oldest, deepest layers, every sample is analyzed with precision. After all, this isn't just any ice. It's amongst the oldest ever found, and they have got only one shot to get it right. The success of this project could reshape our understanding of Earth's natural climate rhythms and provide critical context for the rapid climate changes happening today. In short, this ice core doesn't just tell us about the past, it might help us navigate the future. All the information frozen inside, like carbon dioxide levels, dust content, and even traces of ancient marine life, is a snapshot of Earth's environment from thousands of years ago. It could help scientists understand how the climate, atmosphere, and ice sheets responded to natural changes long before humans were part of the equation. Why is this exciting? Because today's carbon dioxide levels are higher than anything we have seen in the last 800,000 years, and they're rising faster than ever. But what if CO2 levels were once naturally as high, or even higher than they are now? If researchers find evidence of that, they can study how the planet reacted back then, along with how fast the ice sheets shrank, how the sea levels responded, and how ecosystems adapted or collapsed. That knowledge could help scientists better predict what's coming next. As Earth faces a climate shift unlike anything in human history, the truly powerful thing about this core is that it gives scientists a long-term perspective. Climate change isn't new, but the speed we're seeing today is. In just 150 years, humans have pumped more greenhouse gases into the atmosphere than any natural process in recent geological history. Scientists want to know, has the Earth ever faced these kinds of carbon dioxide levels before? And if so, what were the warning signs? what pushed the system to the edge, and perhaps most importantly, what kept it from tipping too far. What makes this particular ice core such a huge deal is that it could finally give us more information about one of the Earth's most mysterious time periods, the mid-Pleistocene transition, or MPT. Taking place between 1.25 million and 0.8 million years ago, the MPT marked a fundamental shift in how Earth's ice ages worked. Before this transition, glaciers came and went on a regular 41,000-year cycle. But afterward, the pattern slowed, with massive ice sheets building up over 100,000 years, followed by sudden dramatic periods of warmth. What caused this shift? Scientists have theories, but no single answer. Yet, and that's why this new ice core is such a big deal. Locked inside it are air pockets and particles frozen at the exact moments that these shifts were happening. By analyzing these materials, researchers hope to understand how CO2 levels dropped, how ice sheet behavior changed, and what feedback loops might have kicked in to cause such a drastic change in fundamental Earth processes. Some models suggest that a slow decline in atmospheric CO2, possibly driven by changes in volcanic activity, chemical weathering, or ocean circulation, may have played a leading role in the mid-Pleistocene transition. If this core confirms those shifts, it could connect the dots between greenhouse gases and long-term climate stability. But there is more. The MPT didn't just change the timing of glacial cycles, it reshaped how glaciers behaved. Ice sheets grew thicker and higher, becoming less dynamic and more sluggish, in part due to the gradual erosion of regolith, or loose surface material. Before the MPT, glaciers often slid over this soft underlayer, limiting their size. As repeated glaciations scraped away the regolith, ice began to sit directly on bare bedrock, allowing for taller, more stable ice sheets. This transition, captured deep in the layers of the Antarctic ice, could help scientists understand how ice sheets expand, how sea levels rise, and what conditions trigger runaway ice growth. In short, this ice core isn't just a frozen relic, it is a time machine that can lead us straight to one of Earth's most important climate transitions. Understanding how and why the MPT happened could reshape the way we model future climate scenarios. Because if Earth's natural systems drastically changed in response to gradual CO2 shifts over hundreds of thousands of years, what might they do in response to the rapid carbon spike that we've triggered in just the past 150? The answers may be locked away in the layers of this million-year-old ice, and scientists are just starting to melt them free. Even though solving the mystery of the mid-Pleistocene transition is exciting for scientists, it's still kind of a niche subject. However, the new ice core from Little Dome C might hold information that could have drastic consequences for our future. Ice cores aren't just frozen records of the past, they're also powerful tools for predicting the future. When scientists drill deep into ice sheets and glaciers, they're pulling up more than just frozen water, and that's exactly what scientists need to test and improve climate models. The models are used to forecast how our planet will respond to rising greenhouse gas emissions, melting ice sheets, and shifting ocean currents, which are all things that are currently happening due to climate change. Think of a climate model as a virtual laboratory inside of a supercomputer, where scientists plug in everything we know about how the Earth works, the atmosphere, oceans, land, and yes, ice. To make sure that those models are reliable, researchers simulate past climates using real data from ice cores, such as temperature, greenhouse gas levels, and dust content, to see if the models can recreate what actually happened. If they can, great! That means that we could trust the model to some degree. But if the model falls short, well, it's back to the drawing board. Ice cores are critical for this process because they extend our understanding far beyond the last 160 years of direct observations into climates that were much colder, hotter, drier, or stormier than today. So what do these frozen records tell us about where we're headed? For most of the last 800,000 years, carbon dioxide levels in Earth's atmosphere stayed between 180 and 300 parts per million, even during the warmest interglacial periods. We know this because of data collected from ice cores, but today we have blown past that natural ceiling. As of 2024, the CO2 level has reached over 422 parts per million, a number that is off the charts by geological standards. Even more alarming is what's in that carbon. Ice core data shows us a drop in carbon-14 levels, diluted by carbon from fossil fuels. Because fossil fuels have been buried for millions of years, all of their carbon-14 has long since decayed. This old carbon leaves a distinct fingerprint on the atmosphere, one that clearly links the spike in greenhouse gases to human activity. Now with the newly excavated core from Little Dome C potentially dating back 1.5 million years, scientists have the chance to push our climate understanding even further. This core could confirm whether CO2 levels ever came close to what we're seeing today. If they didn't, that is a big red flag. We're now in completely uncharted territory. If they did, the core may also show how the climate system reacted. That kind of information is priceless. It gives us clues about tipping points and the resilience or fragility of Earth's climate. Ultimately, ice cores don't just tell us what was. They help us understand what could be, and that we might still have time to change the way we treat our planet to save ourselves from ourselves. If we zoom out a bit and think about what's happening to Earth's climate today, there are some serious threats to life as we know it. These are what scientists call tipping points. Critical thresholds where a small push can lead to massive irreversible changes. Pass one tipping point and the system doesn't just adjust, it transforms, often in ways that can't be undone for centuries or longer. The scary part? Ice core records suggest we may be inching dangerously close to some of those cliffs, and in a few cases we might have already been dangling over the edge. So what exactly are these tipping points? Think of the Greenland and West Antarctic ice sheets. If these melt past a certain point, they won't stop, even if global temperatures cool back down. This is due to a positive feedback loop. And in this case, the word positive does not mean good. Ice has a high albedo, which means that it reflects large amounts of solar rays back into space, cooling our planet. As more ice melts, the albedo goes down, which causes the planet to warm, which causes more ice to melt, and the planet warms more, and so on. This is a very bad thing. Sea levels could rise by several meters, permanently redrawing the world's coastlines, or consider the Amazon rainforest, which could shift from a lush carbon sink into a dry, fire-prone carbon source if deforestation and warming continue. The Atlantic Meridional Overturning Circulation, or AMOC, a key ocean current, could collapse, throwing weather patterns across Europe, Africa, and the Americas into chaos. These aren't far-fetched hypotheticals, they are real risks that scientists are tracking closely. And here is where the ice cores come in. These frozen archives preserve ancient records of all the indicators that show us how the climates responded to stress in the past. For instance, cores from Antarctica show that during previous warming events, ice sheet collapse and sea level rise followed when CO2 reached levels far lower than today's. That is a flashing red light. It tells us our current trajectory may be speeding us toward thresholds that past climates already warned us about. Even more unsettling is how quickly these shifts can happen. Ice core data reveals that past climate flips were often abrupt, shifting from deep glacial cold to interglacial warmth in just a few decades. If that's happened before, it can happen again, especially now that CO2 levels are higher than at any point in the last 800,000 years. The records held in ice cores also suggest some tipping points interact, triggering one another in a dangerous domino effect. But it's not all doom. Understanding these thresholds gives us a chance to act if we move fast, reducing greenhouse gas emissions, protecting forests and wetlands, transitioning to clean energy, and investing in carbon capture technologies are all a part of the solution. Ice cores help us define where the safe limits are, and they tell us how much time we might have left. By learning from the Earth's past, we can steer the future, because once a tipping point is crossed, there is no going back. The only thing left will be the long, hard consequences of ignoring the warnings written in the ice. The new ice core isn't just an extraordinary scientific achievement, it's a time capsule. By studying this ancient ice, scientists are gaining invaluable insights into how our planet's atmosphere, ice sheets, and ecosystems responded to past changes. In a rapidly warming world, these frozen layers remind us that Earth's climate is powerful, complex, and sometimes unpredictable. But with knowledge comes the power to act. And if ancient ice holds secrets about our planet's past, what about the land it came from? Find out who really controls the coldest place on Earth and who actually owns Antarctica. Or click on this video instead.